Looking for a way to grow your channel faster or just a YouTube partner in general? Make sure to check out the link to freemium partnering down below. Hello and welcome back to Asian Reviews, and today we're going to be doing the review for the Kakomi Ultra Combat Armor case for the iPhone 6, the 6S, and I believe they do make it for the Plus variants and other phone models, but this is specifically, again, for the iPhone 6 and the 6S. I'll be using the iPhone 6S in this video, so that's a reference for you guys. So, this is how the case comes right out of the little plastic bag with no real information on there. So, I'm just gonna kinda wing it. So, it comes in its three main parts. It has the little nice silver backplate, the screen protector, as well as the middle black rubberized little glove. So in terms of size and bulk, this case pretty much doubles the size of your iPhone, as well as gives it some more bulk to the side and height of the phone. Although the actual bulk of the phone will not feel as thick as it looks because there is a nice raised lip on the edge of the iPhone. On the edge of the case. On the edge of the case. So it comes pretty much installed like this. I try to recreate it as much as I could, but basically how to install it, you would pry the little case here open. This is the easiest way, by the way, and slide your iPhone in. So pretty simple, and then you just have to slide the little edge of the plastic material onto the edge of the protector. Just so it'll stay nice and tight, and it's not gonna go slipping out. So again, this is probably the worst part about this case, installing it. I know it's a $10 case, and it's probably gonna be hard to install anyways, but it's actually bending the screen protector when I am doing it, as you can see here. And it's really annoying to get that installed properly, as you can see me really struggling to get this on. Like, it's like, I'm actually putting, like, my full effort in here. This case is worse than trying to put on, like, a Griffin case. Ugh. Like, I literally can't even get this on right now, guys. Because the screen protector is so flimsy, whenever you put any pressure against it, it just goes nowhere. Alright. Using like the edge of the table for more grip, I guess. But sorry, I don't have it on screen. I'm like using my whole body to get this on. Oh my gosh. See, I can't even get this corner on. Trying all I can to get it on. There we go, finally got it on. So after that great little thing, we're on to the actual review for the phone now. So if you actually try to like take apart the three parts of the case, then you're gonna be stuck doing that all the way around the screen, and that is not fun, guys. Kakomi, please get that fixed. Hopefully that shock mount's working pretty good. Anyways, just hit the camera there out of rage. Anyways, let's just get on to the review, I guess. We have a cutout on the top for the camera, as well as the little speaker bar there. Doesn't really hamper any of the sound or the visual ability of the camera. We have the nice plastic, really, really flimsy screen protector, which surprisingly does not have any rainbowing effects. So, definitely nice. Touch ID membrane does work as it should. And you can access all of the areas of your iPhone without much, like, slight sensitivity loss or anything like that. So that's great. Moving on to the bottom of the case, speaker grill is not covered or anything, but the lightning port connector as well as the headphone jack are covered by these little plastic ports that make them very hard to open and use on an everyday basis. So that's another minus. That's a minus right there. But you do have a microphone hole, so that's a plus. And it is pretty protective. Moving along to the side of the case, we have the buttons for the power button as well as the volume rockers and the mute switch. Mute switch is accessible, although it is pretty deep in the iPhone, so accessing with one hand is near impossible. Buttons are pretty easy to press again on the sides of the phone, so that's definitely nice. Moving on to the back, we have cutouts for the camera and flash, so it doesn't occupy or doesn't, hamper that accessibility. A nice cutout for the Apple logo, and we have the back plate, which does come in a few different colors. But now here comes the kickstand, another place to struggle. There we go. That kind of hurt. Hang up, we have a little floppy kind of kickstand here. But it is good for watch for media and texting, surprisingly, so that is definitely nice. A nice addition, that definitely is. Now, in terms of the case, would I buy this $10 case? If I was on a budget, I would not buy this case. In fact, if I was not on a budget, even if I had $1 million and I could just like burn it on anything I want, I would not buy this case unless you are very clumsy. This is not a good case in terms of accessibility to your iPhone, taking it in and out. If you're going to switch it with like a waterproof case like an Objects XD5 or a hit case, then you're not going to be able to take it apart in and out very easily. So I would not suggest this case if you like to switch around cases, but if you're kind of like the iPad users who uses that Griffin case that likes to put it on and leave it in there like forever, then this is the case for you. It does not come apart from drops, and the kickstand's a nice addition. Your ports and everything are nicely well covered. You have accessibility to the Touch ID. Buttons on the side are easy to press. So it's definitely nice if you're clumsier. If you're not clumsier, then you should not get this case. That's just my true opinion. Anyways, that pretty much wraps up the review for this Kokomi case. I've reviewed this case for about a week or so, so this is my honest review. Good if you're clumsy, not so good for accessibility to your iPhone and switching out in between cases. Anyways, that is the end of the review. Make sure to check out Kokomi down in the description. I have nothing else to say. Like this video, subscribe. I'm doing a giveaway, so make sure to check that video out. And yeah, see you in the next video. Peace.